You know, I've had a chance to talk with you for the past 6 months. It's coming on with the Breakers back in November. I know for a fact you wouldn't have been happy with the results on Sunday.
No. I mean, how can you be? And like I said, a lot of credit to Memphis. They're a lot of the reason why we played how we played, and they won the line of scrimmage. I thought we did a good job of on defense of stopping the run. I thought we did a great job of creating turnovers and giving the offense field position, and unfortunately, the offense did not take advantage of those. I thought at times, you know, we could have gotten them off the field. We didn't. They got, you know, some third and extra longs or second and extra longs. They got some chunk yards on us to make it an easier third down, you know, conversion for them, and we just got to play better overall as a team.
Coach, we talk about, you know, the time of possession. Again, 12 and a half minutes for Memphis in that first quarter compared to 2 for the Breakers. Negative 1 yards there in the first quarter. The 3 turnovers in the first half, which matched the turnovers for the previous 4 weeks combined. But what can you say about the defensive play that really kept the Breakers in the game the entire day?
Yeah, I thought we played really well defensively, you know, for the most part. And you know, we had a couple of plays we broke down. That's going to happen, you know. And you know, a couple of plays we hit the quarterback, and the ball goes right into the hands of the tight end twice. And it was kind of that kind of day. And so, unfortunately, you have those kind of days in professional football. Sometimes it's no excuse. We have to play better. But I thought for the most part the defense played pretty good.
Of course, the camera's on you the entire game and you're mic'd up. You showed and voiced some displeasure throughout the game that I think one of the comments was, "This is unbelievable." And of course, I'm keeping it PG there. Just what was going through your head, though, as the game progressed and the ball just wasn't bouncing the Breakers' way?
It's just that's the perfect way to describe it. And you know, just little things just didn't go your way, and that happens sometimes. And now I have to be better myself as well. So I have to self-scout myself every week like I do, and I have to be better. So you know, it's just we all have to be better as a team, and hopefully we will this week.
Coach, a lot of respect after the game. You showed a lot of respect towards Coach Todd Haley before the game. We mentioned it last week. Talk to me about seeing Coach and what he's been able to do with the Showboats, especially with the new quarterback, Cole Kelly, in the past 2 games.
Yeah, I mean, they've done a great job. Like I said, since they made the change at quarterback, they've been playing a lot better. And we knew this was going to be a tough defense to play against. They kept everything in front of them all day. They made us earn everything we had, and you know, we could have tried it several times to get the ball over their head, and just to no avail. So, I thought those guys did a really nice job yesterday. Todd's a good coach, been a great coach for a long time, and a lot of respect between him and I.
Coach, I think you're the perfect New Orleans head coach for the simple reason there's a lot of riverboat gambler in you, and you are not shy about going for it on fourth down. You've been doing it all season. Talk to me about your mindset and your philosophy when you decide to opt out of a punt or a field goal situation.
A lot of it's just feel. Whatever my gut's telling me, and so that's kind of where I follow. I follow my gut, and thought we had a, you know, a situation where we were starting a little bit slow on offense, and I thought, you know, that situation where they stopped us on the with the mock play, we call it mock. We're just line up on the ball right now and try to get some surprise to the defense. You know, I thought we had a really good play call there, well designed by Jimmy Turner, and we just didn't, you know, just we they we they kind of fell into it, and it was a good job by them.
Were you surprised at all that they were able to shut down the running game in West Hills?
No, it didn't. I don't want to say I was surprised when they shut it. They did as well as we didn't counter as well as we should have. But it did not surprise me because they got some really good players up front. They remind me a lot of Pittsburgh, where, you know, they're just heavy-handed guys up front. You know, where, you know, sometimes those guys can be hard to move. And so it shocks me a little they shut us down the way they did. But the fact that the degree of difficulty going in, I knew it was going to be a difficult day to run the football.
What do you need to do now, Coach, this week to prepare for another road game, going to Michigan against the 2-3 Philadelphia Stars? What do you need to do to get the team ready to play? And what's the mindset of the squad right now?
You know, I haven't seen the team since after the game. I'll see them this afternoon, so I'll have a better feel of what's going on with the team, you know, after today. But you know, just to get ready. I mean, like I said, very rarely do great teams lose 2 in a row, and we have to go on the road again, like we did last week, and win a game on the road. And that's our mindset. It's a total business trip, and we got to be ready to roll.